but I wonder about this, and I'm done. I wonder about this. When he says they're going to give an account, I assume that means two things. You have a professor. You're going to give an account daily. I looked at that word account, and black shepherd bring a sheep on the fold at night and just count them or even. They count them and check them. I think he gives a count on that prayer. When he's down praying, I think they, when you come across the names in your church, I guarantee you, Brother Randy, if I had a list in your church, and I can bring you here on this too. If I had a list of the church member's name, I said, do not flinch, do not, just a little bit dead eye, I'll call their names. When I go down the list, I bet I'd notice when you. Well, I wish God noticed. So when we're down praying, and we're saying, well, Brother Keith, and I can say this because Keith is. Brother Keith, God is a blessing to me, help him, encourage him, and he just out there smiling at me and saying, amen, he's a man. He's faithful, and he'll do anything to work for you, or take a bullet for you. So I pray about him, and then I come to another one, and then I start crying. And I said, Lord, I've done everything I know to do. I don't know what else to say to them. I don't know how to help them. I don't know why they won't let me go. That's that grief. So he gives an account daily for them in his prayer life. But I wonder if they're going to be an account of someone else. Judgment seat of Christ to give account of the deeds done in the body.
Right.
And I wonder if there's going to be any pastors, first of all, that stand there and give account to God, brother, first, and God says, you scattered my flock and you didn't do right, and you taught them out the wrong Bible, and you know, and all this kind of stuff, you know, and you abused them, you just took money from them. But I also wonder if there's going to be some of this stuff where some of these church members show up, and for the most part, yeah, they're saved people. By the way, I do have a question mark there. I have a red flag over if you constantly are doing things to grieve the preacher, there's something.
Yes.
Right.
Because
right.
I was on a member of two churches, and when I got saved in this one, it never crossed my mind to grieve my pastor.
No.
It never crossed my mind to do anything to try to discourage him. No. I always want to be at his side and try to make his burden light.
Amen.
But I wonder sometimes when you church members stand there, the Lord says, I have all against it. The judgment seat of Christ. You brought grief. Brought grief many times to the heart. Who was it, Brother Abner, in the Old Testament? I can't think of right now, was it? Maybe in Jacob's family, but he had, somebody had a son, and he married these girls and said it was a grief of mine. It was a grief of mine to his parents. Children, you know there are things you're doing now that are grief of mine to your parents. That's the same principle, being a grief of mine. Your kids ever done anything that was a grief of mine to either one of y'all? Just like you lay in bed, I said, Randy, we got to address that. He's on the bottom. I hope that didn't happen. That's what's wrong. And then preachers do that.
Sure.
Preachers. Some of y'all were out of public the other day with me. And I said, with me. I went through it in context. It was several months ago. So my church was out of place. And I had a man walk over to me and ask me, is everything all right between you and those people? I said, why would you ask? He said, I just kind of said to him. But it shows.
Sure.
Anytime you avoid people, there's a problem. That's why I always did it around my things like for a long time. You know, if people don't want to be in your presence, just leave them alone. No. They don't be in my presence. I need to let you know. Because if I don't do that, I'll get wrong. Well, I'm done. I took pastoral authority and said a few things myself. I love my church. I shouldn't have to say that. You can read anything you want.
It's touched my heart. I want to be like Second Timothy,
yes.
Chapter 1. And Paul here, he's writing, he says, I thank God, whom I serve with my forefathers with pure conscience, that without ceasing, I have remembrance of thee in my prayers night and day, greatly desiring to see thee, being mindful of thy tears, that I may be filled with joy when I call to remembrance the today, he was talking about Timothy. He said, if you bring joy to me when you, when I'm mindful of your tears, I'm mindful of your unfading faith.
Amen.
So you
even his mother and grandmother did.
Yes, sir.
The whole family. Brought joy to the group. Well, Brother Henry, you have.
Amen.
You know the only thing about living right? People give you very little room for error.
Yep.
I don't mean we need more room, but I'm saying at least a little bit. Illusion. I mean at least, not some crazy, but at least. Wow, it's been a good day. Let's stay.